We're going to look at protection today. Hi, I'm Menno Fitzky. I'm head of Asian art at Rijksmuseum. And of course, protection is a big thing in a museum. And you see behind me two guards. And they, of course, protect the museum. In Japanese, to protect is mamoru. And derived from that is omamori. And an omamori is a little protective bag of silk. And it contains protective writing. You can buy them in temples and you can have them for all sorts of subjects like traffic or safe childbirth or peace in your family. Here we have two Japanese wooden temple guardian figures and they stand at the entrance of the temple to protect the temple from evil. And the wonderful thing about these sculptures is that the act of protection is so clear, isn't it? The whole posture makes evident that they're trying to ward off evil. And they look a little bit angry, but they're not trying to put us down. They're just trying to protect the temple terrain. They're not angry at us. They are, of course, first and foremost, wonderful art objects. Art offers protection, but it also needs our protection. You know, art objects can be very fragile and they need to be protected. Protection is something we have throughout Asia. In temples, you have protective guardians standing on either side of the doorway, because an entrance is a point of transition, and points of transitions are weak points, so they need that guardians to protect. And you can see here from the Kala face on top is, as in the temple guardians downstairs, yes, he's very strict, but he's also benevolent. It's not about scaring you away. It's about trying to make you behave. The idea in Buddhism is not that your life is completely protected from evil, that everything bad is banned. Life is full of suffering. This is essential. And the idea is to cope with life. And so there is deities like Guan Yin who help you and offer you compassion in this case, infinite compassion. And compassion, knowing that someone is compassionate towards you, means that you're heard. And being heard helps you to cope with life. I feel very much at home in the pavilion. And let us know, where do you feel at home? Where do you feel safe? Thank you for watching and see you next week for another installment.